Democrats and Republicans aside, we all have our opinions of President Donald Trump and our First Lady, Melania. And while we recall Donald's boisterous image from the beginning of his campaign, it seems his wife has always hidden in the shadows. We've asked ourselves who Melania really is, how she became Donald's third wife, and what the inside scoop is on their marriage. And now, we finally have some answers. From the dark to the downright bizarre, here's what we uncovered about the most watched couple in the U.S. 1. Melania wouldn't give Donald her number when they met. As Elite Daily reports, when the two met in 1998, Donald had already been divorced twice when he spotted Melania at a New York Fashion Week party. Melania was just 28 years old at the time. Paolo Zampalli, the event organizer, introduced Donald to Melania that night. But when Donald eventually asked the model for her contact information, she replied with, "I am not giving you my number, you give me yours, and I will call you." 2. Melania was reportedly a very stiff model. With her disciplined Eastern European roots, Melania was certainly disciplined and driven when it came to modeling. The Irish Times says her old roommate reports she wore ankle weights around their apartment and had a very specific diet to keep her in model shape. She still had a tough time getting modeling work, however, even after getting a visa to live in the States. That same roommate says her stiffness was costing her her career, and by the time she met Donald in her late 20s, she considered it might be the breakthrough she needed to kick her career into high gear. 3. Her relationship with Donald helped her modeling career. In the beginning of their relationship in 1999, both Donald and Melania seemed to get what they wanted from each other. As Vanity Fair says, Donald had his beautiful girlfriend that he could crudely talk about on the radio, and Melania received a lavish lifestyle in return. And thanks to her relationship, she had a modeling spread in British GQ. In the spread, she was handcuffed to a suitcase that Trump himself supplied. 4. Hillary Clinton was at their wedding. As the Hillary-Donald feud continues well into his presidency, it's surprising to know Hillary was actually at the couple's wedding. When Melania and Donald married in 2005, the New York Times reports Hillary and Bill were at their nuptials and they looked happy to be there, too. The Clintons and Trump were both living in New York at the time, and Bill and Trump even reportedly played golf together. Of course, their relationship was all business. But the bad blood between the Clintons and the current president didn't start until much later. 5. Donald likes that Melania is less needy than his other wives. Seeing as this is Donald's third marriage, he's chosen someone who appears to be much different than Ivana and Marla. While his previous two wives seemed to be more high maintenance, the New Yorker reports Melania says she's not a nagging wife. Donald has reportedly not taken much interest in her home country of Slovenia or her culture, but for Melania, that's okay. "I'm not that kind of wife who would say, learn this or learn that," she says. As far as the publication could tell, she doesn't even tease Donald, but rather obediently compliments him. Donald loved when Melania would praise him. Going along with Melania's seemingly obedient attitude toward her husband, Michael D'Antonio, author of The Truth About Trump, says he noticed something troubling about their relationship, Vanity Fair reports. D'Antonio says when he met Donald and Melania, Donald said to his wife, "Tell him I'm a really good husband." He repeated this to her twice before she finally told D'Antonio her husband was great, but it seemed to be dragged out of her. The author also said Melania had another wifely duty praising Donald's fame by telling him he was more well-known than other actors or rich folks. 7. They agreed to have children as long as Melania got her body back. We know by now that Ivanka appears to be the golden child of the Trump family, but Melania wanted children of her own. Here's where things get weird, though. As Marie Claire reports, the couple had a contract of sorts before her pregnancy with Barron. Donald wanted to ensure Melania would get her pre-baby body back, and she assured him everything would go back to how it was. Of course, there are conflicting reports here, as a spokesperson for Melania claims Donald was a very warm and supportive soon-to-be dad at the time. But others say he seemed to be quite cold and transactional about the whole thing. 8. Donald has said terribly lewd things about Melania on air. Trump hasn't just talked crudely about his wife on the air once but quite a few times. As Newsweek reports, back in 1999 when Trump was talking Howard Stern, he said he'd groped his wife in public. He also gave details about having sex with his wife and raided other women's bodies. In an even more horrifying interview, Trump has said even if Melania was in a car accident, he'd stay with her as long as her breasts were intact, GQ reports. 9. The couple believes in classic gender roles in their household. As Melania puts it to parenting, her first job is to be a full-time mom for Barron. She's the primary caretaker for him as Donald goes about his business life, and even when she's pursuing her own passions, she's still the one Barron sees on a consistent basis. And when Melania was asked if Donald helped with childcare duties, she responded with, "He didn't change diapers and I am completely fine with that. It's very important to know the person you're with. And we know our roles." Even with her domestic duties, the First Lady still maintains that she thrives on her do-it-yourself outlook on life. 10. Melania defends her husband against his sexual assault allegations. Many women have come forward since Donald's presidency with allegations of sexual assault. Though Melania hasn't said too much surrounding the matter, she did brush it off by saying she's forgiven Donald for any previous misconduct, and we should do the same. As People reports, Melania has said that while Donald has done some offensive things, we need to focus on the important issues facing our nation and the world. And if he says he's never sexually assaulted the women that have come forward, then Melania says that's proof enough for her. 11. And she has dismissed her husband's crude statements as boy talk. You remember the infamous locker room talk Trump scandal? While most of us were appalled, Melania didn't consider it all that offensive. As she said, "I know how some men talk, and that's how I saw it." She even joked about it, saying, "Sometimes I say I have two boys at home, I have my young son and I have my husband." Between the sexual assault allegations and Donald's crude speech, it seems Melania's pretty forgiving. But she doesn't want you to feel bad for her after all this, as she also noted, "Don't feel sorry for me. I can handle everything." 12. Many thought she had a body double. It's no secret the Trump marriage is full of secrets, and in many photos, Melania looks less than thrilled to be with her husband. The latest conspiracy says Melania actually has a body double to fill in for her, as that's how much she can't stand being around Donald. According to Metro.co.uk, there's plenty of evidence to suggest Melania's not anywhere near the White House, and that she's in fact still in New York. This theory has been widely debunked, but even so, it really had us wondering about the state of their marriage. 13. Ivana calls herself First Lady and Melania isn't having it. Melania is certainly the First Lady to the American people, but not to Ivana, Trump's first wife. CNN reports Ivana called herself the real First Lady in her new memoir. Instead of sitting back and letting the ridiculousness run its course, Melania wasn't having any of it. She fired back by saying Ivana's comments are attention-seeking and self-serving noise, according to her communications director, Stephanie Grisham. Though sources maintain Ivana and Donald are still friendly following their divorce, this particular comment seemed to bother Melania more than others. 14. There may be some competition between Ivanka and Melania. When it comes to playing favorites, Donald doesn't try to hide the fact that Ivanka is the golden child. This also means the first daughter takes on many of the responsibilities that usually belong to the First Lady. Daily Mail Online reports a White House spokesperson reassured that Ivanka and Melania are still close, no matter what reports say. But other sources said the two haven't always gotten along, as Ivanka took over some of Melania's responsibilities. Still, we'll have to wait and see if any competition between mother and stepdaughter would put a rift in the marriage. 15. Some say she didn't want to move into the White House at all. Though it took a lot longer than many other first ladies, the day finally came when Melania moved into the White House. While many say she's excited to delve into the role of first lady, others sensed some reluctance upon her move. As People notes, she originally stayed in New York so her son could finish school, and Donald instead moved into the White House without her. That's not all, though Melania also loves her independence. Moving into the White House with Donald seems to take a bit of that away from her. Perhaps we'll see if the presidency and move affect their marriage.